Now my all-time favorite book on maple trees. This is by Lois Ehlert, and it's called Red Leaf, Yellow Leaf. And if you will humor me, I would like to share this book with you. Okay. I also love just the art of this book, this sort of kind of cutout motif. I think it's really visually fun. Red Leaf, Yellow Leaf, Lois Ehlert. I've been saving this little leaf from my sugar maple tree so I could show it to you. I love my tree. It was born long before I was. The wind blew seeds from the big maple trees in the woods. They twirled and whirled as they fell to the ground. Seeds the squirrels didn't find lay sleeping among the leaves until they were covered with snow. When spring sun warmed the seeds, they sprouted and sent roots down into the soil. Tiny leaves unfolded on their stems. I think my tree would have been happy to stay there forever, but one day nursery workers came to the woods to collect tree sprouts. Look at all the little details going along as we read. They transplanted the sprouts and tended them year after year. Just as the trees were settling in, they were measured, marked, and uprooted again. Each ball of roots was wrapped and tied with twine. My tree was loaded onto a truck filled with other trees and delivered to the garden center. We went there in the fall and picked out my tree. Dad had a hole already dug, waiting for it. When we got home, we lowered my tree into the hole. I held the trunk while Dad covered the roots with soil. Now, every night before I go to bed, I peek out the window and wave to my tree. When it snows, I hang up treats for the birds. Each spring, I look for signs that my tree is growing. By late summer, the crown of leaves is bushy and green. I love it when the tree flowers turn into winged seeds. But if you want to visit my tree, come in the fall. That's my favorite time. Can you guess why? The end. Thank you for celebrating 95 years of us here at the Scott Arboretum. We've enjoyed your time and we look forward to your visit. Remember, we're open 365 days a year and we welcome your visit. Take care, everybody. Most of us, we didn't start with those books. We started with some little more visual books that kind of break things down a little bit. And so one of the key things about maples is this beautiful fall color that we see. So if you have a little one in your life, neighborhood kid, grandchild, your own child, and they're asking, why are these leaves changing colors? Betsy Maestro does a really good job, stage two, so it's a really early beginning reader book, does a great, wonderful job of saying, explaining kind of scientific terms, but easy to understand. Why do leaves start to change colors? What's happening there? So a little bit of whimsy mixed with some science. So it's a really great book to help explain the process and what's happening with these leaves. Okay, so that's a good one. Marvelous Magical Maple is another kind of fun book that also does the same thing, gives maybe a little more of a personal perspective to it. Talks about the tree, what's going on with the tree, talks about sugar, the sugar maple, harvesting that. And again, goes through the whole kind of process and life stage and a whole growing season of that maple tree. So another really great book. Now, of course, maple trees, we kind of mentioned in both those books, you saw a little bit talking about the process of getting maple syrup. So this is a fun book that has more of, I would say, dives into maybe a little history, a little tall tale, a little what if. So there's lots of different theories of how people discovered maple syrup. And this is The Maple Moon. And in this book, there is a young indigenous boy, and he kind of has kind of a physical handicap and kind of excludes him from doing a lot of things, but he does quite possibly end up maybe discovering maple syrup. So this is a fun sort of story that kind of tells the tale of how people maybe first discovered that sweet, sweet syrup that we love to put on our pancakes and waffles. A little bit of a more in-depth reader, but definitely a great, easy to read book with anybody of any age. So that's The Maple Moon.